to the spirit and traditions of Ivy League football. It does a service to everybody in this room. And also, I'd like to thank the Penn Nominating Committee led by Gary Buehr. He made the phone call to me. But also, I think I'm the ninth name on the list, right, Penn football players to have this honor. And I know most of them. But I look down that list, and to see my name on the same list with a gentleman that Chris referred to earlier, the late, great Chuck Bednarik, just blows my mind. Was and is a legend in Philadelphia. So for me to see my name on that list is just unbelievable. But you know, back in those days, I played in the early 60s, and the Eagles played their games in Franklin Field on Sunday. So the Eagles around, many of them around the campus, in fact, some of them hung out in the same bars we hung out in. And my sophomore year, and I want to tell you a story, and the guys who played with me know this story. Sophomore year, we did our summer camp up in Hershey, Pennsylvania. And the Eagles did their summer camp up in Hershey. And we shared the same training facilities. Our locker room was on one end of the building, and their locker room was on the other end of the building. And we practiced on the lower field, and they practiced on the upper field. And we shared trainers, the same guys who taped their ankles, taped our ankles. So one day, we were scrimmaging. We were doing the red zone scrimmage. And one of our linemen, a big guy named Ron Notar, lost his contact lens in the grass. So at the end of practice, Coach John Stigman lined up the whole team from sideline to sideline along the goal line. And we all got down on our hands and knees. We started crawling along in the grass looking for Ron Notar's contact lens. Meanwhile, the Eagles are on the upper fields. And they look down. Tommy McCoy, who was the trainer, one of our trainers, told the story. He said, one of the Eagles says, what the hell is the Penn team doing down there? And Maxie Bourne, who was one tough cookie from Georgia Tech, looked down and said, oh, must be some kind of Ivy League agility drill. No, the irony of the story is Maxie eventually came to the Ivy League. The Cornell guys know. He coached up there from 83 to 88. And in fact, he won a championship in 88. Do we have any Maxie's boys here tonight? No? Anyway, it's a tremendous honor for me to be here. And I want to congratulate the other gentlemen up here today. It's a privilege for me to share this evening with all of you. It's great, such a great bunch of Ivy League football players. Thank you very much.